All right, here we are for the second round. We have won the die roll this time, and we've got a mulligan here. This hand needs to draw both islands and white spells, and that's a lot to ask. I'm gonna ship this one back. It just doesn't really do much either. Yeah, that's better. This one's got some action for sure. How about that gleam, huh? All right, your move. Unclear exactly what I want to cast next turn, whether it's Updraft Elemental or Sandstorm Charger. I think it's going to be the What's Updraft Elemental because it's a card that blocks a little better if they have a haste creature of some sort. Also, I don't really mind if it dies so much. Where this one, I kind of don't. Or this one over here, maybe this one over here. I kind of don't want it to die, really. Also, I could just Gurmog Drown away the thing if I want. I think I'm going to wait on that, though. And this turn, I'm just going to cast the Student. Student should get in the way of that Morph pretty easily. So I think it's just like a slightly safer play as it gets immediately roasted. That's fine by me. I'd rather have these things around anyway. Pacifism. Feel like just drowning away this stupid Updraft Elemental, but the card's not a blank. Yeah, I'm just going to wait. Because this sequence can work out pretty well for us, too, where we have stuff to do with our mana for a long time. Twin Bolt. All right, well, can't seem to keep a creature on the table outside of this dumb Updraft Elemental, but we are just going toe-to-toe. Here's Ire Shaman. All right, what was exiled? Sweet! Card which they cannot cast, so that worked out well. Also, the Gurmog Drowner is going to match up well against this Ire Shaman. So would a Sandstorm Charger, though. I could just do that. There, 3, 4, 4, 5. I'm not proud of it. Goodness sakes. Really? Roast Twin Bolt Bathe. Just everything's dying. Alright. I think I've had enough of my creatures not or ceasing to exist here, so I'm just gonna go ahead and play the Drowner now. And you know what? Kill my own creature. Why not? Everybody else is doing it. Gotta feel like I can do better, though, with a top four than an Updraft Elemental. And I can. Illusory Gains or a Mist Hoof Kirin? I think I want the Gains. Kirin's nice, but Illusory Gains can be a real pain for your opponent. Oh, you're getting blocked, buddy. All day. Oh, I can't block it. I forgot. It's less than that. Yeah, all right. Well, I will Illusory Gains it, maybe. Maybe just pacify it. I can now Light Form. Can't Light Form and pacify. Can't Light Form and Sandblast. I can't pacify. I can pacify and Sandblast, but that's not really a thing here. Yeah, let's just steal it. Gimme. This way we're not getting attacked by it next turn either way. But you know, I think I'm going to leave this thing back. I know it's like super conservative to leave back the Drowner, but I just don't want to get dashed on for a bunch of damage here. We've got a nice hand. Tarka Monument. Now I'm going to get in for 5. And then I'm going to play the Dromica Warrior here and just leave up Sandblast. If my opponent plays a smallish dash creature, I can trade for the Warrior. If they play a huge one, oh, that's pretty good. If they go for the Monument, I can just kill the Monument with Sandblast, which is exactly what I'm going to do here. So this works out fine. I get to kill that thing. I get to keep beating down and play Light Form. Ooh. That is better. That is better. This can give me an instant board state, especially if my opponent, just if their only play is like, I'm going to play some creature, I can pacify it and get in there with Infiltrator and just make a big board state. We will rock you. All right. So it looks like our opponent's not on too much dash stuff. They're down to 2 cards, but we haven't actually seen any dash things yet, so that's something I'll keep in mind. The Seismic Rupture in the main deck, of course, is something that's really going to stick out to me as well. All right, so we hit a land and a thing. I need to play something. It could just be a Territorial Rock. If I play that and he kills one creature, he's still dead. Yeah, I'll just save the Light Form in case something drastic happens. This still leaves any one creature dying means that my opponent's dead. All right. So, we're facing a deck that has seemingly infinite removal. Maybe some cards that can actually, you know, end the game in a short period of time, though we didn't actually see those outside of the Monument, which is a pretty slow card in and of itself, so not a huge issue. Let's see. 2 toughness creatures seem to be an issue there. We've got a lot of those, unfortunately, but I don't think we can do a whole lot about it. I feel like cutting the Warrior's fine. Like, it wasn't really doing much and it dies to everything, including half of a Twin Bolt, which I'm not really happy about that either. Hilariously, the Updraft Elemental is like bulletproof. It takes like the Bathe and Dragonfire to kill it. The Roast doesn't hit it. The Twin Bolt doesn't hit it. The Seismic Rupture doesn't hit it. We somehow sacked our best creature. Which is pretty funny. It's still not that good though. You know, the Gleam of Authority, we're going to have to be really careful to make sure that we get value out of it, or that we have a couple of random things with +1/+1 counters on them. Because if it gets out of range, you know, if our creature ends up being a 5 toughness or a 6 toughness creature or more, we can feel pretty safe as the red removal can't really touch it anymore. And it can happen pretty quickly, as we saw in game 1, the thing can just get out of hand. So we'll keep that in mind too. What do we want to bring in here? Something huge like the Durgar Nemesis, maybe just an Ancient Carp just to clog up the ground and not die to those removal spells. We could bring in our package of removal and Gurmag Angler, which look pretty good against this deck too. If it's going to be more of a controlling burn you out deck, then we could actually find these. I want to see a little more from the deck. If it ends up having a dash element, if there's a few Sprinting War Brutes, then these go down in value to me pretty significantly. All right, welcome to the team. Normally, I think I'd like the Durgar Nemesis, but I don't want to have a couple of morphs out and get Seismic Ruptured out of the game. Oh, this looks good. It's a nice little hand right there. We've got the Bulletproof Updraft Elemental. And we've got Valorous Stance for some scary bomb. And we've even got Ojutai Summons now to kind of work our way up the chain. Yeah, this is where, like, Updraft Elemental looks pretty darn good. get in the way of a Kolaghan aspirin and live to tell the tale. Maybe it draws removal, but either way, that's pretty good. All right, we've drawn our top end. This is a nice little draw for us. Because this elemental is going to take some attention. Or else it's going to just start blocking this aspirant. Yeah, all right, well, we'll trade it for a trick of some sort. The Valorous Stance would be decent to leave up here, but it can't kill the aspirant in most cases. Even in this case, it doesn't kill it. So we'll just trade it for a combat trick here. All right, I'm going to go ahead and just play this thing face down. I consider just waiting on it, but we've got expensive plays for days here. Just trading these off seems okay to me, or even just leaving it up. Yeah, I'll just take it. I'm not that worried about this. Plus, my opponent might think, well, he doesn't want to block with it. This morph must be really important, and he'll use some removal on it, which I'm fine with too. Do it. You got to roast it now. I'll just do nothing. Okay. So here I can play Ojutai Summons and get that train going, or I can just pass the turn back and leave up Enhanced Awareness or flipping up the Charger. I think I'd rather just do that here. Doesn't feel like my opponent's going to have too many ways to interact with this. It's a good use of my mana. All right, let's get the big tricks out of the way here. This is Twin Bolt, one to me. It's not what you want to do at all. Okay, well, if Twin Bolt's what it is, or another pump spell or whatever, then that works out fine for us because it's 2-for-1 in our favor. Pump spell doesn't get it done. Twin Bolt doesn't get it done. I mean, it kills our Sandstep Charger, but doesn't save the aspirant here. So I think this works out. What is it? Tail Slash. Yeah, see, it's just a 2-for-1. And in fact, my opponent's entire turn just got sunk into that too. So I feel perfectly fine with that outcome. And now we get to make some flyers and start getting it in the air. Make a morph. Sure. Ooh, Infiltrator, that's good. Oops. Play this guy and ship the turn back, and we're in a really nice spot here because I can actually just block the morph and give my Infiltrator indestructible. If this is the play, I can just fly over with my Jinns. Epic Confrontation. I'm trying to decide if I want to save my Infiltrator or not. If I do save it, it's still just facing down this. No, that this actually does work. So I save this thing, and then I pacify this Glade Watcher. And then I get to attack with the Infiltrator and either force a chump block here or let my Infiltrator go off. I think that's a good sequence. That's worth it. I'm not super stoked to pacify the Glade Watcher, but I am. Oh, that's interesting. But I am happy to force that particular action. I think that's still the play I'm going to make here. I don't know if Illusory Gains actually changes this. I could just steal the Glade Watcher, use up all my mana for the turn. And then attack. Yeah, maybe I'll just do that. Yoink. Yeah, this is just a tough spot for our opponent because We get to activate our Jeskai infiltrator now, and then we get an infiltrator and a planes. If they've got the seismic rupture, it'll knock out these two things, but also the morph, so I'm not too worried about that. Any big bombs our opponents want to play, we end up getting them, and they get their stupid Glade Watcher back. It's a good position. Once we hit that sixth land as well, we'll have a better air force going. Pretty cool if they do have removal in their hand, which they probably do. My God, Tail Slash and Epic Confrontation. And then the first game, we saw all those red burn spells, Roast and Twin Bolt and Bathe and Dragonfire, all that stuff. They might want to try to take out one of these, because the problem is if they pass a turn back hoping to, just unmorph and be able to block what we bring, I can just pacify proactively, and it's a pretty huge blowout. But if they've got a big creature card in their hand that they want to play, then we get it, you know. So, not a great spot for opponent. And, oh, they guessed right. How do you run so good? Just flipped a coin on it and got there. Oh, that is so brutal. And then you're going to bathe one of our flyers. Yeah, this all makes sense. So, yeah, I'm just going to attack here and here. I don't mind a trade for this manifest, and I'm just going to play Scion of Ugin. The cool part is that since we didn't hit that land yet, the Bathe and Dragonfire hit a 2-2 flyer, and instead we're going to get a 4-4 flyer out of the deal. What was that? Guardian Shield Bearer? Sure. So we kill in two turns with the clock that we have. And that was Fierce Invocation, and we got our opponent's 4-4, and it's a Den Protector? Oh my god. So can we kill them? 4, 8, 10? Yeah, just kill them. All right. That was it. So that went pretty well for us. I think, like, my gut tells me that wasn't a great matchup for our opponent, even though their deck looked really sweet. I mean, all the removal spells, Den Protector there, clearly a good deck. I think that maybe it just didn't match up that great against our deck because we could kind of maneuver around the type of things that they were doing. So, and also weren't really affected by having most of our stuff dead. We had a lot of threats. That really wasn't the problem. So anyway, we'll see you guys in the finals.